A very good morning, dear students. 10th grader, I hope you are fine. In today's session, we are continuing with computer chapter 1, that is introduction about internet. In this chapter, as per your syllabus, the topic is related to the internet or network. What do you mean by network? Basically, a network, it is a combination of or group of two or more computer system. It is a combination of two or more computer systems. When they will work together, it became a network. So, a network is a combination of two or more computer systems that are connected with each other. The purpose of connection is to share the information. It can be the sharing of information, it can be the sharing of resources. Generally, a network can be designed in the form of, if you have listened about LAN, MAN and WAN. LAN is your local area network, MAN is your metropolitan area network, while WAN is your wide area network. Now condition, if a system is not connected on network, what it is called? If a system is not connected on network, what it is called? So the answer it can be given, this system is called autonomous system. Which system is not connected on the network, it is known as stand-alone system. It is known as stand-alone computer system. Now, which system is connected on the network? Which system is connected on the network? That can be also known as autonomous. It can also be known as node. It can also be known as workstation, which is connected on the network, which can share the information. In which type of system there is a master-slave relationship? In autonomous system there will be a master-slave relationship. One system will be master, rest all will be the slave computer system. Slave means to say all will work as a client, it will work as a server. So this is about the type of network or what is network system. Now if I'll ask, give me the example of internet. Because network is a group of computers that are at least two or more than two. What it is called if you speak, what is network of network? A network of network is known as internet. What it is known? It is known as internet. When a group of network is connected with another group of network. So, next topic is internet. Internet means networks of networks. Networks of networks. When a number of networks are connected with each other, this is known as internet. If we'll discuss about the history of internet, as per the history of internet, first time internet came in market, that was established in 1969. Network came in 1969, the name was DARPA. The full form of DARPA is Defense and Advanced Research Project Agency. Afterward, changes performed because in DARPA there is a number of problems for communication. So, it was advanced by another name, that is ARPA. It was known as DARPANET. Afterward, it named as ARPANET. ARPANET basically perform some additional feature other than DARPANET. Now, to improve the quality of ARPANET, to improve the feature of ARPANET, we need some satellite signal. To use the satellite signal concept, we use the concept of Aloha system. Aloha system is the system that is used for the purpose of satellite signal transmission. It is also known as linking the satellite network. And finally, it became the internet. Now the question arises, who was the developer of internet or network of network? It is Scurf and Kahan. These are the developer of the term internet. They have developed the term that was named as internet. The answer is Scurf and Kahan has developed the term that is known as internet, or that is also known as interneting or network of network. So if anybody will ask when initial idea came in market, the initial idea came in market for internet in 1961. In 1961, idea was generated. And who developed this idea? This idea was developed by Leonard Klinrock. He think about the idea to share the information by using the network system. This idea was then start developing in 1969, and day by day it got developed, and finally it became internet. It is the structure of internet technology or history of internet. Now, where we can use the internet system? Internet can be used for any purpose, either for industry, either for business, either for education, either for research, either for banking system, either for telecommunication, either for railways, either for airline. So there is a number of uses of internet. So as per your book's point, it helps to transfer the information from one place to another place. One is sharing of information, sharing of info, first use. Second use, internet can be used for educational purpose. We can use it as an education tool by using different software. Internet can be used for transfer of news broadcasting. It can be used for business purpose. It can be used for research. It can be used for entertainment. It can be used for money transaction. That is also known as online business. These are some application areas. So there is no any area where we can't use internet. Either in reservation, either in education, either in banking, either in research, or in business, or hospital. Everywhere internet can be used. Now next topic, how to assess the internet. To assess the internet, we are having three types of connection. How to assess the internet? To assess the internet, we are having three types of connection. One is dial-up. Second connection, we can speak broadband. And third, it can be a Wi-Fi. Dial-up connection, basically, it is developed with the help of landline phone. It is a small area connection or small area covering connection, limited speed, and only one device can connect. Because dial-up connection can be established with the help of landline, it was the starting of technology. We are taking as a landline, as a dial-up connection, and the major problem was that speed was very less, and even the connection breakage was again and again. That's why this connection is not in use. And we can only use on one device to connect. We cannot share it on other devices. So these are the problems with dial-up connection. To remove these problems, so the next connection came in market, that was known as broadband connection. In dial-up connection, we need the modem that is helpful to transfer the signal from digital to analog. If anybody will ask what is the full form of modem, so the answer will be modulator, demodulator. Next is broadband. Basically, broadband is a high speed connection. It is a costly system, and for that we also need modem. But it has some features. It can cover a large area and multiple users can use the same connection. Users can share the connection. Broadband is costly, but it is high speed, large area covering connection. Multiple users can share the same connection on same time. Now, broadband connection can be used by Wi-Fi or wireless device. Connection can be wired, it can be a wireless. Wi-Fi is a type of wireless connection. Wireless connection can be performing three types. It can be a Wi-Fi hotspot, or it can be a WiMAX. Wi-Fi is a wireless connection. The major feature of wireless connection is there. We don't need any wire or cable signal. That's why cable cost is reduced. It is less costly. But wireless connection has some problem that it will not provide the stable speed of network. The speed of network is not stable. It is not fixed. It can be reduced up or down. What is the benefit of using Wi-Fi hotspot? Wi-Fi hotspots will provide to share your connection without paying any additional charges. Any additional charges, you can share your network up to 16 devices. You need not to pay anything, only you should have one internet connection. And WiMAX is a high speed connection that is generally used with the help of microwave technology. Its full form is Worldwide Interoperability Microwave Access Network. That is used by a large organization for high speed network. It is a very costly network, that's why it is used by big industries. It is generally not used by a single user, and it provides the speed of broadband. Minimum speed it will be provided, it is 100 Mbps. So WiMAX is the faster speed connection that will provide a good service for a society or a good organization. Now, what are the advantages of internet? Recently we have done, internet can be used anywhere, in any area, in any field, like in business, research, education, entertainment. But along with that, we are some having disadvantages. So what is the disadvantage of internet? Very first thing, if we will start using access, it is a bad habit. It is a major disadvantage of internet. Second is, chances of virus are more. Third is, loss of information. There are more chances of loss of information from hacker side. So there are some reasons due to that internet is also harmful, basically for a society or environment, and it will also spoil your mental ability. If you use excess, it will also spoil your mental ability because you are already occupied in same system. So these are some major disadvantages of internet. Afterward, types of modem. Modem can be generally of two types. It can be internal modem or it can be external modem. Modem can be of two types. Either it can be internal or it can be a external modem. Internal modem, that is fixed inside your computer system. A user need not to remove again and again. It is already fixed in your inside computer system. While external modem, it is a portable device that can be port anywhere and that can be connected with any device anytime. It is a outside device that will directly connected with USB cable. So dial-up connection generally use the internal modem, while broadband and wireless connection generally use the external modem. Now come to the next point, that is World Wide Web. What do you mean by World Wide Web? World Wide Web, basically it was developed by CERN in Switzerland. So basically in 1990, the purpose of World Wide Web is to access the page on a complete world on internet. So every business now has internet presence. Email has to be taken place of ordinary mail. So every page, either it is social media page, either it is your website page, either it is your specific web page, to access the web page on internet we need the service, that is World Wide Web. Approximately more than 70 million pages are available on World Wide Web. More than 70 million pages are available, and it will change according to environment, because it can be used for educational, business, military, government, every purpose it can be used. When we are using the World Wide Web, so we need to access the web page. So how to access the web page? To prepare the web page, we need a specific language, that is hypertext markup language. Each page has some specific address, that is known as URI. Or URL. URI means Uniform Resource Identifier or Uniform Resource Locator. Now we need some protocol. To access the web page, we need a protocol that will hold the information, that is known as Hypertext Transfer Protocol. So full form is Hypertext Transfer Protocol. URI is Uniform Resource Identifier, identification we can speak, while HTML means Hypertext Markup Language. These all three resources are required to prepare and access a web page. One language is required, one address is required, and one set of protocol is required. It, these all combined together will work on World Wide Web. Now next topic, that is what are the features of World Wide Web. World Wide Web have some features. If anybody knows, Dash is a hypertext information system. So answer is World Wide Web is a hypertext information system. Second advantage, it is dynamic in nature. It means it can change according to the requirement of web pages. More we can speak, it is a cross-platform system. Cross-platform means to say it is not dependent, it is independent system. Fourth point, approximately 70 million active web pages are available on www. And fifth feature of World Wide Web, it is dynamic and interactive. It is an interactive system to assess the internet services, and it provides multiple services, not for single service. These are some major features above World Wide Web system whenever we are using on the network. So in today's session we have covered till the topic World Wide Web. Today we have covered about what is network, types of network, what is internet, how to assess the connection for internet, which types of connections can be created, what is www, and what are the features of www. In next session, we will meet with next video. Dear students, if you are facing any doubt in any topic, you can give me a personal call or you can send me a message on WhatsApp. My number is 999111890. So thank you. Have a nice day for this session. Thank you so much.